Understanding the Unix display architecture, and when we talk about Unix display architecture, we necessarily talk about two different concepts called as the X server and the X client. This is because fundamentally the way Unix handles a display is a lot different than the way Windows does it, and that is because Unix handles the display setting using two different concepts, the X server and the X client. In Windows, we do not have any such concept. Whenever someone works on Windows, it is assumed that all the machines do have their own display, because Windows primarily were not meant to be a server operating system. They were mainly operating platforms for end users. So since it was an operating platform, hardly you would see a workstation without a display, isn't it? So that's why the way Windows handles it is completely different than your Unix handles that display. Since there are two components involved, X server and X client, it's called as like a tier. So tier deployment can be on different machines altogether. So one of the most common examples of we deploying it is a Linux example, where both the X server, which can handle display, which could be a hardware or software, is installed on the same host as your X client. X client is a software which needs someone to handle display on its behalf, and it's primarily a software, a program. Normally both these stacks, the X server and the X client, are installed on the same physical machine in a typical Linux case. A Linux machine runs in run level 5, which can handle display. Now provided your server should have that display hardware, which is nothing but a graphics card, then only your server can handle display. Although the architecture is still a client server architecture, but both the components, the server and the client, are physically installed on the same machine. However, things are not always going to be the same way. You may, however, choose to run it in another mode, a distributed mode, where my X server is running on one machine and my X client runs on another machine, and somehow they are connected to the network. Now, whenever my X client, which needs to have someone on its behalf handle that display, would request that display service from an X server, and this can happen over a network, then if the X server allows some client to use its display capabilities, the X server will handle that display. But before that, we need to know what exactly is this X server and X client. So when we say X server, we mean hardware and or software which can handle GUI or the graphical user interface. So when I talk about an X server, it has knowledge of handling display, and by display we mean that whenever I talk about a hardware or a software which understands display, it means that hardware or software understands what is the size of my screen. Size of a screen is in terms of number of rows your screen can display, and number of columns on each row that particular display or that monitor can handle. The screen depth is the number of colors a particular screen can display, also called as, in short, resolution. The pixels per say area of on your screen is called as the screen depth. The screen coordinates, so if I want to launch a window, where exactly should it be launched? So those windows are to be positioned, or those GUI objects are to be positioned somewhere on the screen, and that somewhere position is always identified using the X and the Y coordinates. So it is that software or hardware which understands these aspects of handling display. It can also register your mouse movements, mouse clicks or keystrokes. So if I'm talking about a X server, and if I move my mouse, so it moves that pointer on the screen using that X and Y coordinates of it. If I type something on that GUI display, it can capture the keystrokes verbatim as is, and then it forwards those mouse clicks or keystrokes back to the X client. Now it's the program which then takes the necessary action. Say for example, I have a client program called as Xcalc, which is a calculator, say for example. Now it's a client program, it cannot be launched in a text mode. I want some kind of a display facility because there are a lot of buttons there on top of your calculator. Say for example, if I launch a calculator here, a calculator is not a text tool. It requires me to display a framed contents, which we call typically as a window. Within that frame content, I need to display buttons, I need to display various other objects, say, of interaction, that is radio button, check boxes, if there are any fill in the blanks, then I am able to type in some keystrokes and so on. Then this display itself is being handled by the X server. So if I move my mouse, it's the job of my display server, X server, to figure out where exactly the mouse has moved. So if I then click on a particular button like this way, it passes on the coordinates back to the client saying this is where the mouse has clicked in. Now whatever is the underlying logic on button click will be running on the client machine, or that X client will do that thing. So the moment I clicked on this clear button, so whatever I typed earlier was reduced to zero. So this logic is built into the X client. But my mouse movement, that my mouse has reached over that position, is with the X server. Otherwise my X client doesn't know anything about handling the display part of it. So, and your display can also optionally have a capability to chart windows. By charting windows we mean whenever I say Xcal, where exactly the window should pop up, on what X and Y coordinates that window should be shown. It could be a flat window, or it could be a true type window in a 3D mode like this one. Like this window has got some beveled environment where you can see some bounces, and then there are some crust, and you can figure it out. Or it could be a very plain window, like a picture, a 2D picture, where you cannot make out that there's shadowed portion somewhere, and there's so it will be a plain colored window. So your X server may optionally have a capability to chart window, and by window we mean not the operating system here, we mean a framed content. When I say window, a window has a frame, a title bar, it has some shortcuts menu, like when I click here, it pop up move, minimize, close, resize and whatnot, and it has these three typical buttons called as minimize, restore and maximize. So whenever you display your programmed contents in a container, that container itself is called as a window. Now this facility may be built in into your X server, or X server may make use of a specialized software to handle only windowing part, and that is called as a window manager. In case of a Unix, some of the most common window managers used are TWM, Midnight Commander and etc. There are a whole lot of window managers. Each has its own style of displaying that window. You may additionally have an option to apply themes. You get a different styled menu and so on. So the way the contents are present in a frame would change from window manager to window manager. And this capability may be very much built into your X server itself. It depends on what kind of a X server I am using. And then X server is also responsible to notify the client or to the window manager what type of an end user, graphical user interaction is happening. So whether the user has clicked in on a certain button, like the way I am clicking. So these keystrokes or the mouse clicks are conveyed back to the client, and client takes necessary action. Or if I am clicking on one of the windows menu, then it communicates that those interactions, GUI interactions, back to the window manager if window manager is a specialized program. If that functionality is built within X server, then X server will handle that functionality on its own. But whatever I see within a window like this one is purely a X client program. it can only do the programming part, it cannot handle the presentation part. It only has the processing logic, not the presentation logic. Okay, coming back to XClient. XClient is any software that needs to launch a GUI program. Any program that needs to have its own GUI is a XClient. So whether it's a gedit tool, whether it's a calculator tool, whether it's a XIs kind of an utility, all these programs that needs to have that display in place is called as a XClient. Your OUI, Oracle Universal Installer, is a XClient because it needs to pop up some display, and that the display needs to come within some window. So XClient program is only known to handle the processing logic, not the presentation logic. Now where exactly the window needs to be popped? What should be the screen depth? What are the supported colors? What is the X and Y orientation of that window? Everything else would be taken care by your X server. And those keystrokes or graphical user interaction is then communicated over to the client. Now that communication may happen over the network if X client and X servers are installed on separate machines, or it could be within the machine if both X client and X server programs are installed on the same machine. A typical example is Linux. Say in this model, since a typical Linux system has both X server and X client installed on the machine, the interaction within will be within the machine. But consider another way of deployment where a X server is a machine which has a hardware or software that can handle display, which is a separate server in a network, and then I have another machine in the network which wants to produce that display, which becomes my X client. Now whenever I launch my OUI on this machine does not have any display handling facility. It requests it over the network from the X server. Now the way to request it is via a couple of settings. Now it's up to the so client only has the program logic or the processing logic but lacks display capabilities. So client, in other words, has only the processing logic, and the server only could have a presentation logic. So it only knows how to present, while client knows only the processing part of it. Now when it comes to X server, it's X server who decides whether or not to allow a particular client to use its display capabilities. Otherwise, if you have a X server which does not prohibit, then everybody probably will clutter your screen, sending all of their GUI requests onto your screen, and you cannot figure out which one is your program now, because there are too many clients who are sending their display onto your machine, and your monitor is cluttered with all different types of applications that the people are running from the X client machine. So your server must have a choice whom he should allow, whom he should not allow, and that the server does it using the XHost command. So if a server wants to allow anyone within the network to use its display capability, it simply says XHost plus, means anybody, unrestricted, no discrimination made, any client can use the display capabilities offered by this server. How to use that client will be made learned using some other setting. But client, the server has to allow or disallow or selectively allow a couple of them, and selectively a server can say XHost plus so and so IP address. Means a client who is running on this IP address only can make use of my display capability. And if I am fed up of handling display, I can say none to all. So this means nobody can use my display capability, which also is the default setting. So until the client expressly allows, until the server expressly allows, no client can make use of the display capabilities offered by a given server, either on the same machine or on a different machine. Clear? The next thing is, now that I know that in my network there's a particular machine with the IP address, say 192.168.0.1, which can handle the display, how does my client send that display request to the server? The client is made aware of the display capabilities available somewhere on the network using the environment variable called as display. So client says export the display, and you normally say IP address where your X server is running, followed by colon port number where the display software is running. Example, somebody at a client side may say export display equal to 192.168.0.1, which is the IP part of it, and then say where exactly is my display port, which is colon 0.0, or simply saying somebody may say the this and this is one and the same thing. 192.168.0.1:0, this is where my software is running. We'll get back to that, what exactly it means. Some of the commonly known X servers are hardware graphics cards. So if you have that hardware facility to display, then there's no question of you using a software. That hardware alone can handle that display. But assume that I want to make a particular machine as my display server in a network, and that the server does not have any hardware to produce that display. In such a case, you can also make use of a software. Some of the commonly used X server softwares are VNC server, Xming, Hummingbird Xseed, Reflection. Some of them are commercial products, while others are free or open source products. Now, placement of this X server software itself and the X client. Normally, when you install Linux, which by default runs, which by default is brought in run level 5 with GUI support, which means both the X server and X clients are installed on the same server, that is the physical box, physical server. When you choose to run your Linux server in run level 3 without display capabilities at hardware level, then you can make use of the X server software like VNC server, either on the server, or use remote display server like Xming, which will run from the client's machine, that is your laptop. So I will show you a couple of things. Now assume that I want to launch a display. I want to log on to a particular machine, say 192.168.0.180, and I want to run my a GUI tool, some GUI tool as user Oracle. So I logged in to the Oracle user on a given box. Since I logged in as Putty, if I say xcloth, it says you can't have a display because Putty is just a purely a command line tool. So I cannot have a display. So if I launch my xcloth, which is my X client, where should the display go? I didn't mention that. So my display cannot be handled. Okay, so I figure out any other machine in my network which can handle that display. So let's say, for example, I launch the display on the same server because I do not have any other machine running in Linux, I believe. We'll launch the X server software somewhere within the network itself. I am launching it on the same machine, but let's say, for example, I am launching it as root user. So I want to provide that X server capability. I launch VNC server. I say where to launch that VNC, launch it on say port number 2. Once the VNC is launched, I need to make it secure by saying VNC passwd, so that not everyone can use this one. This is the worst way to launch a VNC because you are launching VNC as root user. If somebody makes a hacking attempt and can successfully guess the password, your entire control is with that user. This is the worst way to launch it. Although my focus is not security, my focus is to explain you the X server and X client. Okay. Now when I say ps-ef grep vnc, I can see that my VNC server is running as root user on the port number 2. This is being running as root. I launch that VNC by going to that particular IP address on colon 2, which is my port number. I am using from my client machine a tool called as VNC viewer. I log on, and this is it. So my client, I make it aware saying where is my display running by saying export display is equal to localhost, because it's on the same machine. You can also optionally type in the IP address, colon port number. So my client has been now made aware that this is where you need to send that display, or can you can request that display. But my client, my X server so far has not authorized anyone to use that display, see what happens. My client then says, launch the X client program called as XClock. It says, no, that's not possible. Although I did set the display, it says it was refused by the server because my server hasn't authorized anyone. Default setting is Xhost minus, means nobody can use it. Okay, now I am allowing globally, saying everybody within my network can access my display capabilities. Once server allows it, my client says one more time, display that clock. So although the program is running here, the display comes here. Now, where I am moving this window, on which X coordinate, Y coordinate, this my X server is passing on to the client. Now, there's no user interaction required for this program, so there's no question of passing back those mouse strokes or taking an alternative action at a client level. But assume that my program is like XCalc. My client launches it, the display goes on to the server. Now, whenever I move my mouse, see, highlighting of that window means every time my mouse makes a move on the screen, those coordinates are being passed from my server to the client, and client takes the alternate action, that is to highlight a button. So there's a continuous communication using the client and the server. So here in this case, if I click on a particular button, my client doesn't knows where the mouse has clicked. Server passes on the X and Y coordinates of that mouse back to the client, and client comes to know, okay, this is where my button 9 digit is, and that's how it displays it back. Okay, that's said and done. I terminate this program, so the display is washed off. The moment I think, okay, I don't want to allow a particular client from using my display, I say, I have banned 192.168.0.180 client from using my display. If the client says now XCal, okay, although it's using it, it shouldn't allow someone, or let's say generic no to everyone. I think I used it. Is it this way? No. Yeah. Shouldn't matter actually, but I want to say generically no to all. So I said generically no to all. Now if my client says again launch XCal, it gets an error saying client has denied your connection. Okay, this is when you have on your server a software which can emulate itself as a X server. In my case, it was a VNC server. What if my server does not have a hardware, my server does not have a software? How can I get that remote display? Okay, I'm closing all its down. So I do not have any VNC server software running on my machine. So I close it off. I close all the sessions. Then you can make use of a remote display server like Hummingbird Xseed or Xming. I launch on my laptop a display server called as Xming. So once I launch Xming, it shows up in my tray. So this is my Xming, which says it is currently running on :0.0. Then I launch my client. I launch it by saying 192.168, the IP address of that target machine. Then I go to down the line in SSH section X11. Then I say use X11 forwarding. Excuse me. Use X11 forwarding, and then I put my display as localhost :0, because this is where on my machine, on my laptop, is my display server Xming is running. The moment I log in as Oracle user, and if I say echo $display, display is automatically set for you. You need not worry about what value it has been set to, because it changes, it keeps on changing. So you need not worry that it will be always. You just need to enable X11 forwarding. If I launch a XCal program, the display comes all the way to my desktop, on my laptop in here. So it's over the network that it's coming. Now why it is able to launch it, it's solely because I am running on my machine a display server, a X server. If I close this X server, my program will also go, because I have closed that display facility itself. So in cases where you do not have a software located on the server which can work as a X server, In that case, you might install that X server software on your laptop and then use X11 forwarding, which is also called as SSH tunneling, to tunnel the GUI traffic using that SSH tunnel. So it's all the encrypted traffic between your machine, that is your laptop, and the server where your exact X client software is running. So this is how the client software architecture in X server and X client typically in a Unix environment works. So we have seen in one case where X server, we launched it here, and X client was also on the same machine, but since display was being owned by root user, we had to expressly say allow using client. But if I launch the VNC server using the same user, then there's no need for I to say anything to anyone. So I log out, I log in one more time. This time I log in and launch VNC server as Oracle user itself. Since I am myself, I can always launch it. There is no exhaust required because it's my launched X server. So for me, it doesn't ask any permission. But for someone who wants to make use of my display, there would be a permission applicable. Okay, launching X server and X client is one technical thing, and then there's a responsibility part. When you are all done, always remember to kill the VNC session, because if you keep it open, it sounds like you are indirectly helping the hacker. So always, the moment your program is done, your job is done, always kill the VNC session, because somebody might guess your password, and if it is guessed, then he pretty much has all the control using the display facility. He can even shut down your machine. So this is how that X server and X client works. Basically, it's only about two commands: X host for the server to allow or disallow someone, and for the client, it's only about an environment variable called as display. Thanks for joining in for this short session. I hope this session was useful.